seats. Yeah, those meeting seats. We're finally doing it!
Hello, everyone. Hopefully this is working.
We don't know if it's working. Comment below if you can see us and hear us. That'd be helpful. Amber's over here on the side telling us, you're good, you're good. So it's time. We finally got in here. After an extra 4.5 month wait of waiting for this beauty to be built, we are here. We've been in it for about 6 days now, right? 6 days?
Yep, we got it last Friday.
Yep.
And what a whirlwind.
Yeah, it's been pretty crazy.
All the stuff we had to pack and get into every nook and cranny of this, and you'll see some of those here in a little bit when Jen does a tour.
Yep. So I think this wine is going to be well-deserved.
Yes, we've been holding on to this bottle for, what, 2 years?
So.
And then we kind of held on to it because it was a special bottle we got from one of our favorite wineries.
Mm-hmm.
But then when we decided to do this, we thought we would wait to have it until we were on the road. So we're finally on the road. It's time to crack open this bottle.
Yeah, hopefully it's good. It's been in storage units waiting for us, back of trucks, for different Airbnbs.
It was in the bed of the truck for a couple days going down the road,
yes.
So we'll see.
Yeah. So what is it? It's Adelaida Syrah
2010 Reserve.
Are any of you toasting with us? If so, let us know.
Yeah, what are you toasting with? Let us know.
Oh, boy.
It's not going to explode. It's not champagne.
It's been jostled around. I don't know how these things work sometimes.
All right, let's see. Doesn't smell bad, so.
Let me try to get my nose on that. Okay, this is really weird. This is our first live stream, and it's weird that no one's talking back. We can't hear you, Chatty.
Well, we do have Amber check for comment questions, so feel free to ask questions at any time, and we will try to answer. A little bit for you.
It's hard to get distracted. There's people outside walking their dogs, doing all the camping things.
4 times as much for me.
Wait a minute. It smells good.
It does. All right. Hope everyone has a glass. So to big adventures in this rig as we travel around the U.S. And we're going to dedicate this season to all of those who wanted to do this. And maybe had something come up and weren't able to. Cheers.
Cheers. It was worth waiting for.
Yes, very good. Very good. So,
yes.
What do you want next?
Doug has a quiz, or he has game show.
That's right. So here comes the first game show. And if you guess, person closest gets bragging rights, because we're not famous yet and we don't have anything to give away.
No prizes.
No prizes yet. Maybe sometime in the future. But for now, just for fun, Amber's going to put up a picture of the rig so you see it from the outside.
You've probably seen it already. You might have seen it.
Yeah. There it is. So the question is, with a full tank of fuel in the truck and the RZR and all of our stuff in the RV, how much does it weigh? So
write your comments below.
Put your guess in the comment below. So it's how much does it weigh? That's with no water or anything in the RV. But how much does it weigh? Closest gets bragging rights.
With us sitting in it.
That could add quite a bit after the current 15.
Any comments or questions, Amber? If not, let's take the tour.
All right. So Jen's going to give you the tour of the living section. I'll take you through the man cave later. Let's see how this works with moving around the laptop.
I'm going to drink some more of this because I've got this live thing going.
All right.
So first, we're starting in the kitchen, but we'll just go ahead and go up to the master suite.
The master suite.
I'll tell you all about it. Go up our grand foyer. And here is the master bedroom. King size bed. You can kind of see it in there. Here's our closet, another closet. Lots of storage under the bed. And that's kind of all that's in here.
What's in the closet?
This is not a What's in My Drawers Wednesday episode. Okay. But into the door, I'll show you. I don't think it's too terrible in here. So here's the closet. So quite a bit of space for an RV. And you can go back here. Shoes and more clothes back there. Lots of hats. I plan on having lots of hat days for camping here.
We're not camping.
Not camping. No, we're not camping. We're glamping. We don't really like getting dirty. Though we have an RV and we have a RZR. So go figure. This is the kids' closet right now. So Amber and Jackson both have their own little shelving unit there. And then once they head off to school, we're going to put a washer and dryer in there. It's already set up for it. So that would be really nice. Now I'm using a laundry mat, which was interesting. We did that for the first time. Had a chat with people, so that was nice. Doing the RV lifestyle. So what am I doing? Are we going back this way?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. This lifts up. I don't know.
Better view of the bed and the windows behind it.
So this holds more stuff under here. So yeah, lots of storage. They kind of use every nook and cranny they can in there. Now the master suite. This RV has two bathrooms. It's one of the main reasons we like this. Two full baths. So here is this guy in here. Ta-da! So it's pretty decent size shower. Doug can get in there and turn around and do all the hair things and little sink, medicine cabinet. And this big guy, again, more storage. It goes like all the way down here and then all the way back there. Still working out the kinks and where to put everything, but that's working for now. Follow me to the dining room and the kitchen.
Okay. What happened to your leg? Why are you limping?
So yesterday we're in the Smoky Mountains right now. And I'm trying not to get distracted by the side conversations. We're in the Smoky Mountains right now. We took a hike yesterday. And for some reason, I think I'm still 20 and I think I'm still in shape. So instead of taking a bridge around this trail to go to a waterfall, I crossed this tree with the kids and I'm on there. And I've got one camera in my hand, so I have no balance. And so I leaped at least 20 feet, I'm sure. And then I landed on it wrong, so now it hurts. So, yeah. You have any questions, Amber?
I do have a comment from Sarah Gordy. She is saying that she's sure that you love chatting with strangers at the laundry.
I actually did. It was the strangest thing. I think I liked it because I was never going to see her again. So if I was awkward and weird with her, it was just like, whatever. I wasn't going to see her again.
Also, I have another comment from Tabitha Bryant saying she loves your shirt.
So this shirt, and I love this shirt because it's social distancing Sasquatch, and I was doing social distancing like way before it was a cool thing to do now. And this shirt's actually printed by the oldest friend I know who's probably watching now, Natural State Printing. They have their own company, and they print off shirts, and I'll put a link below later so you can check it out. So, yeah. You have another question?
Dan Phelps is asking what kind of brand of wine you have.
Oh, this is Adelaida. Adelaida Syrah 2010. I believe, Dan, you were with us when we got this, or when we became members there. To the tour. So here's our grand kitchen. We have the island. Kitchen sink is underneath here. Usually we hide some dishes under here for company.
See if I can get a better angle for you of the whole kitchen. There you go.
So yeah, actually, we're able to put all the dishes away. Another bonus about living in such a tiny house is it only took us 5 minutes to clean the whole thing before we were able to welcome you in. It doesn't take very long to clean up this much space. So we have the island, more cabinet space, a nice big full. It's quite residential size, is it?
Yeah, it's 18 cubic feet. It's it's the size of a smaller residential perch.
So we decided on this one because it can do propane and electric, which means when we want to go like off the grid and do some boondocking or whatever, we can always have a fridge because it'll be on propane. So yeah. Then we have our oven, which we've cooked one pizza in. Surprise, surprise, the Stanley's Ring Pizza. did an okay job. We're still learning how it all works. And then convection microwave oven. Again, still learning how all of these things work.
We have more ovens in this rig than we had in our house.
Yeah. I tried to make biscuits in this yesterday, and they didn't turn out well. I forgot.
We're like, wait a minute. Anyway, there we go.
I had to hit start. Luckily, Jackson said he likes when his biscuits are doughy. So it'll probably be good.
Bonus.
Yeah, bonus. Over here, we have a pantry. Love the pantry. So much space. So, still working the details out on that. There's all that. We even brought the KitchenAid. We love pizza, and that's the best pizza dough maker, so we're able to fit the KitchenAid in there. Now, welcome to the dining room. No, not the dining room. Oh, yes, dining room.
Oh, dining room.
Hi! There's Amber fielding questions over there. Here's the living room. So we got our little theater seats, they recline, the massage heat, all the goodness. We got our party lights up in the dining room.
Ooch, 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 ooch.
Yes, Amber.
The Hansons want to know where the pizza is.
The uni is in the basement or the dungeon. We have several names for it. It's the big storage underneath. We won't be able to go out there today because it's getting dark and I'm not sure if it's raining now. But we'll have another video of like another more detailed one. But yeah, we do have it with us. Oh yeah, so the Hansons are the reason we have the uni. We went to their house. So good.
What are you watching?
I am watching some great TV. If you guys want to watch some entertainment, you should subscribe to this awesome channel. You can actually do that right now. and I don't know if you can tell, in our fireplace down here, it actually produces heat. Or just ambiance.
Yeah, it was important to us when we got out on the road that we have electric and gas for everything. So
yeah.
That produces heat, and we have a heat pump AC.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Above me, there it is. This is Amber's cubby hole. She likes sleeping up there, and Bentley sleeps up there with her.
You may have seen that in a post.
Maybe, yeah.
The Bentles.
The windows. This is another reason we chose this rig over some other ones. It's just tons of windows. And as much as we don't want to have the dirty camping feeling, we still want to have the camping feeling of being out in nature. So this did that for us. So now I'm going to take the camera, and then Doug's going to show you the man cave, or the slash hashtags, all the things.
Yeah, so this is primarily a garage, but it really only is a garage while we're on the road. We use it for the office. We use it for a place to play cards, all the things. So
Jackson's bedroom.
Jackson's bedroom, guest bedroom, guest suite, because there is a bathroom back here. So I guess not a lot to say. It's 12.5-foot garage that we roll out the carpet in, and it has a Happy Jack system, which is what this is.
You are a good cameraman, because I cannot get the angle.
Just hold it high in that seam. There you go. So these fold down into a queen bed. They have cup holders. The table goes away, so you can have a queen bed down here. And then these raise up and bring down another bed way up top here, which is a second queen bed that we actually always leave set up for Jackson. So he'll come here, he'll fold those down. He flips a few switches, and then his bed will come down on the elevator system. You can see a little bit of that here. See, they move up and down. So that's kind of cool. And then there's a separate entry back here. And most importantly, there's another bathroom. It's not as big as the master bath, but it is a bathroom. I'll turn on the light. Oops, wrong button. There we go. So it is full bath, so shower, toilet, and sink, even though the sink is super tiny.
I'm not sure I can get that.
Yeah,
you got it. Angle.
So tiny, there is no room to hang the toilet paper holder. We're not even sure where to put it, but we'll figure that out. If anybody has any ideas, let us know. We were able to hang our first picture a couple days ago. So this used to be over a fireplace in our Sticks and Bricks house, and we found this is the only wall in the entire rig big enough to put it on here. But we plan on filling out all of these missing states as soon as we can. Mm-hmm. Hawaii is going to be hard to do in this rig, but we will include all flying and cruising and all of those things.
Oh, and tell them about one of our other favorite part out in back. That's
yes. So another reason why Toy Hauler, even if we weren't always going to have a toy with us, it wants this room for an office, but also, if I can squeeze over here, it has sliding glass doors that lead to a balcony. So the ramp out back turns into a balcony, and this will be where we typically have our sundowners or evening cocktails. So that'll be fun. We've already used it a couple times, and it's awesome. Let's take you back inside, and do we have any questions, more questions and comments? All right, let's go in there, and we'll answer those.
There's our neighbors. Oh, wait, maybe I can show you a picture of Pebbles sitting outside.
Yep, there's Pebbles, and she's in her black dress right now, being protected by the rain. All right, I'll put you guys back over here. Where's my wine? Wine and Q&A. All right, hit us with some questions.
All right, so first off, we have from Mixalina wants to know what the make and model is.
This is a 2021 Grand Design Momentum 397TH.
I'd also like to know, where does the poop go?
In tanks below, and then down the sewer. We'll go over kind of the whole technical specs of it and how all the stuff works, because we have found that even having it a week, there's things you do constantly to keep the systems running. So I'll go over those in when we do our full tour video.
But good to know that Doug and Jackson have already released the tanks on our last trip. We were in Nashville first, and now we're here in the Great Smoky Mountains. So we did have a transfer already. They cleared the tanks and had no poopsies.
No poopsies.
So, woohoo! Success!
Okay, what is Pebbles? Or who is Pebbles?
Oh, Pebbles is our Polaris RZR side-by-side. So it's our off-road vehicle. Because remember, we don't like to get dirty.
Yeah. 2018 Polaris XB Turbo.
Yes.
Anywhere we want.
How much
big
is it to park?
We park, right now, this summer, we'll be doing mainly like RV parks and RV resorts. The reason for that is we wanted to have reservations because we have a tight time frame and places to be. So the first season, if you will, of the summer will be all going RV park to RV park with a few
Harvest hosts
and Boondockers Welcome, which is kind of overnights in between. We plan on parking it on some BLM and other boondocking places where it's free. So trying to experience that and see how it goes. There'll be a lot of upgrade videos coming because this rig is really set up well for RV parks out of the box. We even have a generator that we got with it, so it does well even if you're boondocking, but there's a few things we can do to make that going off grid a lot better, and I just placed the order for all those today. So sorry, Tia Christina, your garage will be full of our upgrades, and we'll have an upgrade week at the house.
And with all of that, we averaged about, for now during the summer, it's going to be about $40 a night at the RV parks.
Yeah, $35
to $40. So that's what we're averaging during the summertime.
Christina wants to know where you're getting all your mail.
We actually have a mail forwarding system in Mount Juliet where we used to live. And they scan all our mail in for us, and then we can just read it that way. And if they want us to, if we want them to send it to us wherever we're at, they'll package it up and then send it to us.
We've had a couple people ask how tall the ceilings are.
Tall. Yeah, so I'm 6'1", and so that would be like 8-ish feet. I would say they're 9.5 to 10 feet. The entire rig from the ground to the top of the ACs is 13.5 feet. So it's tall.
There are tunnels we can't go in, so we have to watch.
Yes,
yeah,
we have to use trucker navigation systems that warn over weight, length, and height. So we can't just use Waze. It could get us in trouble.
Jason Smith wants to know where Jackson is.
actually just saw his head pop up. He was hanging out in the pool. Now he's hopping on his bike.
Yeah, one great thing about RV resorts is a lot of them have pools and hot tubs and volleyball and just all kinds of amenities that you wouldn't get like at a national park. So it's been kind of nice. It's our second one. And the first one had live music every night.
It was Nashville.
Nashville. And then this one has, they pick up your trash at the front of your site every day. Mm-hmm. They have a hot tub and pool and just lots of stuff like that. They have laundromats on site in an RV resort. And the sites are a little closer together, but you get a lot of amenities out of it too. So.
So yeah, he opted out of doing the video. Yeah, he opted out of doing the video so he can go play.
He's been doing that most of the day.
Yeah, I think he's had fun today.
Having a lot of fun.
Hope Weaver wants to know what's in the fridge.
What's in the fridge?
Oh boy.
Food and beer. Oh, and Dom Perignon.
Oh yeah. So lots of condiments, milk, Cholula, eggs, and beer. He likes his beer when we're camping. I was thinking about that the other day, but I think at some point the newness of camping will probably wear off, and you won't want to have beer all the time like you do now. Like you're like, oh, I'm outside, I'm camping, I gotta have a beer.
Mm.
One day it might just be it's Tuesday.
Mm.
We'll
see,
we'll let you know.
We'll see.
How long are we staying here?
At this place in particular, we are here until
31st.
Okay. Is it more or less expensive than owning a home?
You can go either way. This summer, I think
we're
going to about break even.
Yeah, so our plan was not to save money by going this route. We wanted to have something that was big and comfortable that we could live in full time and not a lot. I highly suggest that do what you can afford. So if you have a pop-up and you want to do this, go do it in a pop-up.
Yeah, start where you're at.
Yeah, start with what you got. Yeah. We knew that our lease was coming up on our house, and we knew what our budget was. So we basically said if we can do it for the same amount of money that we were doing in a house, then that would be good enough for us.
Yeah.
So that's why we went ahead and got something big and nice that will last us, and we'll have plenty of space and an office and all that.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, and long-term plans, we're thinking when we are ready to settle back down, we might stay in here while we build a house. So we're thinking long-term.
So the rig is a lot cheaper than a house, but you have to pay to park it somewhere.
Yeah.
Then Dylan Wright wants to know if we plan on making any empanadas.
Oh.
That'll be hard because of the frying.
We're coming to your house for that.
There you go. There you go.
What is the square footage?
420?
440. So we went from 2550, I think, was the house we were in Nashville, to 440 square feet.
Does that include the basement?
No.
Okay. Just living space?
Just the living space, yeah.
All right. So do you want to reveal?
Oh, yeah. Did people guess weights?
I did.
All right.
So let's see. I don't know. You'll have to tell me who the winner is.
Did someone guess one pound?
Yes, was Natural State Printing.
Oh, there you go.
Is this Price is Right?
The Price is Right. All right.
So they were going closest without going over.
Uh-huh.
That's pretty good. So you want to tell them what your guess was?
I guessed 22,000, something like that.
And Amber, what was your guess?
I think it was like 18
pounds because I know what the RV can weigh.
Mm-hmm.
And we were all wrong.
Yeah, Jackson guessed like 20. Somewhere on there,
yes, it weighed in at 31,180 pounds,
and that was before we put $500
of
gas because it holds gas for the razor too. Yeah,
the closest was Mr. Dan Phelps at 35,000.
Whoa,
but he went over,
he did go over.
So, who's the closest without going over?
That would be Travis at 19,500.
Oh, all right. Travi Patty wins bragging rights.
I think Dan's going to think he was robbed.
Yeah, Dan's going to think he was robbed, but he wasn't because it was Price is Right rules.
He did say boo.
That's it. Thanks for joining us.
That was fun.
Yeah, it was fun. If you want more, if you want notifications when we do it again, hit that subscribe button. You can also visit our website. We're super fancy now. You can get like on an email list. That's prone2roamlife.com.
I'm lying. Hold on.
Closest.
Does that work? Did she make it in time?
I don't know. That's up to you guys.
Oh boy. We're gonna have to get our game together before we actually have prizes.
Yes.
We'll get that. We'll get our rules.
So when we actually have prizes, we'll have official rules. Since this was for fun, we'll let them both win. Travi Patty wins, and who was the second person?
Mixelina.
While we're at it, even Dan Phelps, you win too.
Yeah, why not? Three winners. Participation trophies for the rest of you.
There you go. All right. That it?
I think so. All right.
Thanks,
cheers, everyone.
Bye.